Why is it that African-American men, when they feel threatened by a woman, they grab their genitals and wave them around all over the place? Three guesses what he's saying to me. Never mind, he just walked past a little boy and a senior citizen. Never mind, there's other children within earshot, because he's damn near in front of a daycare center. This female encourages him to do what he's doing. She's encouraging him to curse me out, call me out of my name. This woman was just a face in the crowd until she decided to curse me out and grab her phone and say she was going to call the police because I took her picture. I invited her to do just that. 5 minutes earlier, this man walked past me selling his drugs wholesale. The man on the right side of the screen is buying drugs. The man on the left side of the stream has the drugs actually in his hand. I've been trying to take their picture for 5 minutes. They keep turning their back. They actually went inside 200 Leavenworth and completed the drug sale. And this is not the first time I've seen this. This is the fourth time I've seen it. And this is the owner. Let me tell you about what happened to me June 13th this year at 1:49 a.m. A woman threw a container of pudding across the street at me because I was taking pictures. She retreated inside the store. I crossed the street and began to pursue her. When I got to the door, there was a man standing with his arms outstretched to keep me from going in the store. I pushed past him and watched the woman run in the store, go all the way in the back where this man was, where he let her out the side door. Then he proceeded to push me physically out the door. When I told him I was going to have him arrested for touching me, he tells me that he's going to find somebody to take care of me. And while he's talking all this smack, two guys kick my service dog. My service dog bothers nobody. This guy is a runner. Police doesn't seem to care. They let him do what he wants to do. By the way, when I went to the police to tell them about what happened in the store, I was treated like I was a criminal. Ever since Gary Germanis has been gone, citizens who have been trying to assist the police in cleaning up the drug activities are treated like they're lunatics. The longer I stay out and take pictures, the less people are on the corner. By the way, this is not the first time someone's thrown something at me and ran inside the store. June 12th of last year at 1:24 p.m., a woman threw a can of soda at me and ran inside the store. By no means, this is not a new problem. These are pictures that have been taken over a period of a year. This is the first person I've ever seen who sells drugs, who saw me taking this picture and turned around and gave me a big smile and didn't have a problem with it. This woman did. She hit me and ran. This woman is snorting cocaine off of a tin box in the middle of the sidewalk. Police saw her and kept right on going. There's something wrong with the police station in the Tenderloin. Something wrong with the police. There is no excuse, for selling drugs, prescription drugs or otherwise, and it's all illegal. And they know it's illegal. They know they're not a drugstore. They know they're not pharmacists. My service dog bothers no one. It was just unnecessary to harm her. She bothers no one.